Hey, this is Justin with daytrademarkets.com, and I want to talk about the massive sell-off today we had. It's March 22, 2018. I want to talk about it in terms of three clues to help understand this sell-off. Just to give some context, the Dow was down over 700 points. The S&P was down 2.5%. So a big sell-off, and I want to talk about this. Will probably be a little bit of a long video. I want to get really in-depth. So if you're into that sort of thing and you like trying to understand the markets, then this is probably a good video to watch because I'll try to get pretty in depth. Anyway, the three clues I want to talk about are I have an idea that I call the two out of three concept, okay? And so I'm looking at three different evidence points, and I want to go into depth on all three of these. But the first one is the big picture bias. That's kind of the long-term market analysis that's known prior to the day starting. The second one is what I call zone evidence, okay? That's more of an intermediate piece of analysis. It's my take on support and resistance. That is also known prior to the day beginning. Then the third evidence point is kind of what happens as the day is unfolding. So this is what happens in real time. We're looking at what I call aggression bars and also box logic, okay? This is giving us a really good context of what's going on. And the idea is that the more of these that are in alignment, the better your edge, and the better you have an understanding of the direction that the market wants to head, right? So, and this is different. Let me just make one more point before I get into the details. This is very different than the way that most traders, especially newer traders, tend to look at the market. We tend to be focused on this setup, or we're looking for this magic indicator. We're looking for this, perfect indicator. And if you're on that path, which we've all been on, honestly, you're kind of screwed. What you have to be able to do is make sense of the market. And then when you have put the market into context and have a story that's pretty clear and have been able to identify good locations for where the market has to make a decision, I call these decision points, then you apply the trade setups that you want to use. And I teach a lot of trade setups as well, but that's the concept. I hope you get what I'm saying. But let me talk about this in depth a little bit. So big picture analysis, let's look at that evidence point first, okay, and look at it today. So for a moment, forget about these aggression and all these boxes. I'll talk about those in depth and kind of go box by box and talk about the logic. Again, this will take a little while, but forget about that for just a second. What we knew going into the day, you can see we closed here yesterday. This zone was what I call an overlay zone, and the big picture bias was neutral. Now, if we were gonna break above this, the bias would go to leaning up, big picture, and if we were gonna break below this, which is what happened, it would go to leaning down. In fact, I'll bring over the overnight chart, and we can look at that. The overnight chart here is the same idea. This pink zone is the same one that's over here, right? You can see that early in the overnight, we started to, just kind of go sideways, had a little bit of selling, really broke out of here, and really good aggression in the overnight session, actually took it all the way down. So that caused a gap down in the, on the daily chart, and it certainly showed us that as the day was beginning, it was giving us a pretty bearish clue on the big picture level. We opened the day down here, meaning that our big picture was leaning down. We went into the night thinking it was going to be neutral. Evidence that had developed in the overnight tells us our big picture is down, okay? So that's one piece of evidence that it's telling us things are a little bit bearish from the overnight session. The next thing I want to talk about is the zone evidence, okay? These are my take on support and resistance. And again, just for a second, forget about all the price action for the day, forget about the boxes, and just look at these zones, okay? The idea with these zones is that if we're in a zone, like we started last night, the high of this should give resistance. The low of this should give support. But if we're able to break below it or break above it, in this case, break below it, that's a bearish indication. Now, then if we can push into this, that's pretty bearish. Now, once we're in it, this side should give us support. This sh side should give us resistance, all things equal. Now, our bias is down, so we're looking at that. So this is the idea. Now, this should give us resistance. If the buyers are able to break it higher, that would be a bullish indication. But if that resistance holds, then we're probably going to head to here. Now, are we going to find support here, or are we going to break below it? That would be bearish as well. So that's the idea of these zones. And we want to look at those as another piece of evidence. Obviously, if we're trading down below this zone, and by the end of the day we're below two zones lower, we know it's been pretty good selling. These are just some extra pieces of structure that we can monitor. Okay, so that's the second piece of evidence, and you can see just by looking at it, things were pretty bearish on the day. The third piece of evidence where I want to spend a lot of time is on the aggression bar and box evidence. This is kind of telling us what's happening as things are unfolding in real time. So I'd like to just kind of go through this in a little bit of a replay format, I suppose, and talk this through. So let me just put this up here. So we know again that in the overnight market we broke below that zone there, and our bias is now leaning down. So let me just I guess the easiest way to do this, let me just cover this up so that we, in theory, don't know what's coming. Obviously, we know what's coming, but I want to talk about it as if it's the right edge of the screen, so to speak. So when we open up, we see that we have, some pretty slow market, no what we call level two or level three aggression bars. And then our first structure, and so all we know is that the bias is leaning down. So all things equal, we would rather be trading to the downside. If perhaps we come up here to the resistance side of this zone, could give us an opportunity. But really, what we'd like to do is wait for what I call a box, or wait for some aggression to unfold to give us a clue. And you can see that that happens right here. This is our first box, which would have formed about right here. And this is our first box of the day. And so this is a buying box, okay? Now that shows us that buyers, at least on the short term, they did it with some aggression, are trying to basically throw the first punch. They're putting in some structure. They're showing some degree of strength on the day. Now we have to, generally speaking, let me just talk about this. When we have a box, okay, once the box forms, if nothing happens and there's no, conviction in the market, we're just going to stay in containment. We're going to find support on the low, find resistance on the high. However, if buyers are proved to be strong, they're going to be able to break above that box, put in what we call acceptance, and or maybe put in another buying box. That would show buyer strength, okay? Now, on the flip side, if the sellers are really strong or are showing strength, they should be able to break below the box, put in acceptance, maybe even form another box below there, okay? But we just have a box, and we want to understand that this is containment until proven otherwise. Are the buyers going to be strong enough to get above it? Are the sellers going to be strong enough to get below it? That's the idea here. So we have our first structure of the day up back at the, in the day. Our first structure of the day is a buying box. Now, generally speaking, you would think, hey, maybe I'll be a buyer toward the low of a buying box. In this case, however, let's kind of break it down and see what we've got right here at this moment in time. We have a situation where on the big picture bias, we are leaning down. So that's bearish. Okay. On the zone level, we are at zone resistance. Okay. Again, we're at the high of that zone. We should expect resistance. That's bearish. On the box level, we have a buying box, which is bullish. Now, in isolation, each of these are telling a little bit different story, but we see that more clues are telling us we better be careful if we're thinking about going long, and we might want to think about going short, or that's the side we want to think about. So when this box forms, I would advise against getting long, and we have a couple of options for getting short. One would be if the buyers come back up here and test the box and what have what we call a box rejection, that can be a good fade. And there was a couple opportunities we can talk about later in the day. Or if the sellers are strong enough to accept below this box, that would tell us that sellers are pretty strong, and we could think about getting short something like that on a retest of that box. Okay, so let's play this thing forward a little bit longer. And again, we would expect resistance here. This was a pretty good opportunity for the buyers to prove that they meant business if they would have been able to take this aggression that got us to the high of that zone and break above it. Okay, now that's not what happened, as we know. And instead, let me move, reveal the curtain a little bit more. We get this selling box that forms right here. So now what do we have at this moment in time? If we break this down, what do we have here? Again, on our big picture bias, we're leaning down. That's bearish. On our zone level, the last part of the zone we tested was the resistance that held, so that's bearish. Now on the box level, what do we have? We have a buying box taken out by a selling box. That's bearish. So now what is this telling us? Now it's three out of three. Before it was two out of three bearish. Now it's three out of three. Now does that guarantee this thing's going to sell off the way it did? No, it doesn't. But it's telling us when we have this three out of three scenario that the sellers are in charge. They are the path of least resistance. And until proven otherwise, the evidence is showing that the sellers are trying to move this thing lower. Okay? So as a trader, how do you handle that? Well, certainly the most effective or the most conservative way to do that is to wait for a pullback where these two boxes overlap, where the selling box and this buying box overlap. That's a great spot to think about getting short. Now, in this case, it didn't ever pull back that high, right? It just took off lower and made another selling box right here, right? So when this box formed, which would have been right here, what is that telling us? Well, on the box level, okay, we're starting to stack selling boxes. We have two selling boxes in a row below each other. That's telling us things are very bearish on the box level. We know that things are bearish on the big picture level. We do have to use some caution because now we're at a potential area of support on the zone level. So it's not crystal clear that, you know, in other words, we, and the buyers try to step in. You can see a green bar there. They try to step in. Not surprising. Now the question is, can the buyers take this back up here and get above this selling box, or is this thing going to fail and sellers are just going to be dominant at this point? That's the question that we have right there. Okay. Now you can see it barely hesitates. The support does not hold. It tries again with this green bar. That fails right away. That's telling us at this moment in time, it's just kind of the waterfall cascade effect of sellers are really strong. So then we get another box right here. Now this right here to me is a really good opportunity right in this area right here to look to get short. Now, why do I say that? Because, again, we have stacking selling boxes. This is the area where these selling boxes are overlapping. Okay, so that's a good spot in isolation. We have a down or leaning, in this case now, we've just switched to a down bias because we're now below this zone. Okay, so we have a down bias. We have stacking selling boxes. We have a place where the boxes are overlapping. And now that we're below this zone, we would expect if it retests back to the low, that should now offer resistance. So we have kind of three out of three here that really line up beautifully in this spot. We have zone resistance, we have box resistance, and we have a down big picture, okay? So again, now that doesn't mean it's 100% gonna work. It's not gonna work 100% of the time, but it's a pretty darn good spot where sellers should wanna take this thing lower. Now, if buyers can break through there, that changes our story. That tells us something is changing. We have to be aware of that. But at this moment in time, that's a pretty bearish spot. That's a pretty good location to think about selling it, right? So it bleeds over a little bit, but ultimately does sell off from there, okay? And now we start to sell off below again. We get another box here. Now again, this is a little bit challenging because yes, we're selling off like gangbusters, but we do know that potentially we're into an area of support here on the zone level. Again, you have to be, this isn't black and white stuff. This isn't perfection. This isn't certainty. That's just not how trading works. What it is it's different clues that are helping us understand what the path of least resistance is, what the spots that we need to make sense of. So we now have another scenario here where we have the sellers, we have stacking selling boxes. We know that where selling boxes overlap, like right here, is typically a great place to get short. We have a down bias. Everything's looking pretty bearish other than the low of this box is near zone support. Still two out of three. Again, if I wrote that out, what do we have right here? On the big picture level, we have a down bias. That's bearish, okay? On the zone level, we are at zone support potentially. So that's, you know, it's caution. You could say bullish or use caution. And then on the box level, we have stacking selling boxes, okay? That is bearish, okay? So two out of three are saying go short. It's just that it's a little bit risky because we're potentially at an area of buying support, okay? So what ends up happening here? Well, it holds very nicely, and we sell off. And now we really have a chance to take this thing lower. And this is a really good spot, again, where it's very similar, where now we're back inside of the zone. We have overlapping selling boxes right here, okay? And we have a scenario where this area, now that we're back below it, should offer resistance. Again, a really nice spot to potentially look to get short. It should give us some resistance in here. Now, in this case, it kind of bleeds over, and you could say that didn't really work. And I think that's fair that it didn't really work. It did bleed over more than you'd like to see, although it kind of holds. But doesn't really hold. That's our first clue. Maybe, just maybe, things are changing, although that's not enough. Now that we're back below, we want to see, can these sellers take it back and continue to stack some selling boxes? Instead, we start to see some clues. It's hard to see, I know, but there's a level 3 buying aggression bar. That's telling us extreme buying aggression is coming in. And whenever you see that right on the low, buying aggression on the low or selling aggression on the high that's extreme, you at least have to take note. We have to be aware. Buyers, perhaps this market has auctioned low enough to start attracting some buyers. Okay, and that is what ended up happening. We have a little bit of a battle here. And you could see that then we get this first buying box of the day right here. Now, this doesn't really change anything other than it tells us the buyers for the first time in a long time are showing some degree of strength. Okay. Now then what we have is another buying box that comes in right here. So now what do we have? We have a scenario where all day we've been, you know, basically the first buying box failed and then we're stacking selling boxes. This is our first sign that buyers are back in play. Now, what I call this is now we have a two-sided market. At the beginning of the day, we had a one-sided market, all selling. When this selling box here fails and we get the buying box on top of it, it doesn't mean buyers are taking over. There's still a lot of selling they would have to get through. But it does show us that sellers are back in play. We now have a two-sided market. Buyers and sellers are back in play. It's not one-sided or one-sider control. Okay? Hopefully that makes sense. Let me clean up these arrows here for a second. So hopefully, you know, that it's starting to show us, okay, things just got a little more confusing, right? So we have a scenario where we have buying boxes starting to come back in. That's a little bit bullish, but we're right at an area potentially on the zone level of resistance. What's going to happen? What's going to budge? You can see here that buyers did another buying box. So now really buyers are showing some strength. And then a little bit of back and forth here, back below it. But here's overlapping buying boxes right here that held to a degree, but couldn't go and make new highs. One other thing is we did have this box rejection here. When this box formed right here, it looks like everything's great. This is our first sign of trouble for the buyers, this box rejection. However, we come down here. This is a decision point where these two boxes overlap. It holds to a degree. I mean, it comes up, I don't know, four points or so, but can't keep it going. And now the sellers are back below. And now our question is, okay, what's going to happen where these buying boxes overlap right in here? That's our next decision point. Because when we go to, and I'm getting a little bit in the weeds here, a little more in depth than I planned to go, but I might as well just keep going. When we get to a two-sided market, now we have to think point to point. I always call these decision points, okay? Here was the first decision point, this circle here. Can we get above this decision point? No. Okay, we're back below it. Now here's our next decision point. What's going to happen here? Our seller's going to come back in, or a buyer's going to come back in and take us to this decision point? You know, right here. That's kind of our next question. We're in a two-sided market. We have to think point to point. We're no longer in a one-sided stacking selling box situation where it's just trending lower. Now we have a little bit more confusion. Okay, so here's our decision point. We get another buying box. So now our decision point is the low of this buying box versus the high of this one. The buyers break through it. These are looking pretty strong. Here we get another buying box that forms. So now here's our decision point. Now we haven't tested this overlap yet. So we're right up in here as well. Okay, I'm getting a little in the weeds. I might be losing some of you. I apologize. But this is the sort of thing that we talk about and that we learn that you can learn. So now we have a scenario here where if you really look at this, the buyers have such an amazing opportunity right in here to just erase all of the selling. Here was the start of the selling right here. We're right back up to that. They have a chance to erase all this and just drive this thing higher and take this thing to new highs and really change the story of the day. This is their chance right here. What happens? Well, box rejection. Okay, that opens the door for the sellers to come back in. Will they? Well, no, not yet. We then get another attempt by the buyers, actually makes another higher by one tick. Once again, box rejection. We can't, again, like I was talking about earlier, if buyers were strong, really strong right here, what would they be able to do? They'd be able to accept price above the box and maybe put in another buying box up here. And that would have, again, also erased all of the selling from earlier in the day that started over here, okay? That's right where we are, right there. That's not what happened. Instead, we had a box rejection. So what happens? It invites the sellers to come in, just like they did here and they couldn't do it. Okay, buyers have a chance. Well, buyers couldn't do it. Okay, sellers have a chance. We don't know what's going to happen, but we know the ball is in the hand of the sellers, so to speak. So then the question is, what are they going to do? The next decision point is to take it down where these two buying boxes overlap right here. That's our next decision point. So what's going to happen here? This is kind of an interesting scenario. Well, it bounces off of there a little bit. Now what's going to happen here? Are we going to come back up here? Or are we going to break below there? And as we know, it did break below. That's pretty bearish. But here's our next decision point. Again, this area that, you know, has been tested over here. Here's our next decision point. Are we going to be able to break below or come back up and test this higher decision point that's right here? Okay. Again, we're in a two-sided market, so it's point to point. Okay. So we hold right here. Now we're back down to here. What's going to happen over here? Are we going to find more buying, or the seller's going to accept price below there? You know, we don't know exactly yet. And as it turns out, now it really, to me, becomes very clear once again right here. Now we get a selling box, and look what we've done here. We've taken out all of the buying that came in from earlier. We're on new lows. We're also back inside of the zone. So if you look at, just like over here was a really good spot to be a seller, didn't really hold. This is still a really great spot to be a seller right in here. Because again, why is that? Well, we're on the resistance side of the zone. We're at the high of a selling box, which we should expect to provide resistance, and our bias is down. Plus, we've taken out all of this buying in here, right? I know I'm making a mess of these charts again, but that's hopefully you're following along. This is a really good spot. I know it's very volatile, but that's a really interesting spot. This is a very key decision point, and everything's lining up for the sellers once again. Again, big picture is down. That's bearish. Zone level, we're back inside of the zone. Inside of the zone. And at, you know, the zone resistance area, okay, that's bearish. Now, what about the box level? Now we have a selling box taking, you know, taken out all buying from earlier. What is that? That's all bearish right now, okay? Three out of three, pretty darn bearish right in here. Doesn't guarantee it's going to sell off like it did, but that's a pretty good spot, right? Now, our next, what's our next decision point right down here? We break through there without much trouble. We break through the zone here as well. We come back up, and again, it's kind of the same deal here. You can look at the exact same thing right here. Now we're below this zone at the zone resistance. We're at the high of a selling box. The bias is down. Pretty good spot. I know that's late in the day. I don't do anything after, you know, 3:45 Eastern time myself. But that's, you know, these three pieces of evidence, once you learn how to make sense of them, and this is something I talk about in our live sessions and in our training, it's not the Holy Grail. It's not perfection. You're not going to be 95%, but it's going to help you make sense of the market so you can get into good spots, so you can be on the right side of the tracks more often than not, okay? So hopefully that makes sense. I know that was a long video. If you're still with me, I thank you for sticking it out, and let me know if you have any questions on that, and we'll talk soon. Thank you.